the nature of the music in Barcelona screamed for a storytelling. We got stuck for lyrics, at which point Fred said, "Oh God, we're lyriced out, dear. We're lyriced out. You know, Mrs. Rice, give her a call." That was dear old Tim.
I don't think Freddie ever thought, "I'll do this because that's what the public want." I think he would always do what he wanted and hope that the public went along with it. Freddie got in touch with me. I knew he was very into opera. I mean, you could tell that from some of his work, but he was really into it. He knew the major melodies, he knew the divas, and Montserrat was one of his favourite. We got on very well, and then out of the blue, he said to me one time, "Would you be interested in writing a couple of lyrics for me for the Barcelona album?" And I was, very flattered and very enthusiastic, but also surprised, because he writes such good lyrics himself, and I thought, why would he want, someone else? But perhaps he just wanted a slightly different look to one or two of the tracks. He played me the basic tracks of two of the songs. I think by then he'd recorded a lot of the album already. And I said yes, and ended up doing lyrics for two of the songs for him and Montserrat.
The boy had a way with words he sang. He moved with grace, he entertained. So naturally, no gesture out of place, his road in life was clearly drawn. He didn't hesitate.
Freddie said, "You can more or less do what you want, but it can be dramatic." I think he emphasised the fact that he didn't want "I love you, please be true." Although if I'd done that, he might well have been quite happy with it, I don't know. I found it quite a exciting challenge for the two tracks that Freddie gave me, and they were quite complex. They weren't simple songs, Golden Boy and Fallen Priest, and they were theatrical, so I kind of wrote stories around them. I think they worked. I mean, they were never going to be singles as such, I don't think, but when I've listened to it back over the years, listen to them, I think, well, they are very operatic pieces which could could have fitted into a bigger storyline, and that was kind of what I had in mind. Both pieces were quite long. They were more the length and style of Bohemian Rhapsody than they were of, We Will Rock You, for example. And they lent themselves to telling a story, and I thought the idea of a priest who'd gone wrong was quite interesting. And ditto, the Golden Boy was, this star. Maybe I was thinking a bit of Freddie, who had everything, and where do you go from there? Which is an interesting concept, which I suppose I've used before in stories like Evita and even Superstar. And quite often, composers, so to say, tactfully, or maybe not tactfully, "I don't think that's quite right. Possibly you could maybe tweak that slightly," which the subtext is, "This is bloody awful, please improve." But Freddie, I don't remember having, to do much, or when we got together around his piano, I might have said, "Well, I think, after all, I don't quite like that line." And but it was a fairly speedy process. And then I remember going to the studio and watching bits of it being recorded. It was great to see Freddie and Montserrat, at work. I think Freddie would have definitely done something, in the bigger picture. I'm not saying necessarily it's a better picture, but it's certainly to write an operatic piece would have been right up his alley. And he was such a good writer, I'm not sure he would have needed anyone else to help him, although I would have said, "Freddie."